afternoon. It's another day in paradise. Happy New Year's. Welcome, 2020. Today's topic is about my newest addition to my portfolio, introducing Capital One. So let's dive into it. Okay, currently, this is Capital One. I'm inside my Robinhood portfolio. This is my newest addition. I always go to the 5 year. I'm not concerned with the 1 day, the 1 week, the 1 month, the 3 month, the 1 year. I leave that up to the day traders, swing traders. I go straight to the 5 year graph. I'm a long-term investor. Once I buy, I hold forever. Kind of like when I was in the military as a young buck, one of the sergeants used to always tell me, you know, I was a troublemaker, I'm not gonna lie. And they would tell me, you could add to, but never take away. So there was something like military regulation or something. I got into some type of trouble, but they were saying with the regulations, you can add to, but never take away. So I took that as my philosophy of and my strategy on how I invest long-term in stocks. So let's dive into it. Okay, this is Capital One. That's the 5 year chart, up and down. Let me check the peak. I mean, the peak, it's going back to its peak. So it peaked at 105. I bought in at $85. So my total return, 19.73%. The stats on Capital One, 52 week high 105, 52 week low 74, market cap 47.80 billion, PE ratio 9.14, dividend yield 1.55, analysis rating 70% buy, 26% hold, 4% sell. Let's see what else we got. So I bought Capital One on the 8th of October. And then I received my first dividend on this November 22nd. About Capital One. Capital One Financial Corporation is a financial holding company which engages in the provision of financial products and services. It operates through the following segments: credit card, consumer banking, and commercial banking. The credit card segment offers domestic consumer and small business card lending and international card lending businesses. The consumer banking segment consists of branch-based lending and deposit gathering activities for consumers and small businesses. The commercial banking segment comprises of lending, deposit gathering, and treasury management services to commercial real estate and commercial and industrial customers. The company was founded by Richard D. Fairbank on July 21st, 1994, and is headquartered in McLean, Virginia. Current CEO is Richard D. Fairbanks. I already went over the headquarters in McLean, Virginia, founded in 1994. Employees, 47,600. So I'm going to go to two more sources for Capital One. I usually go to Wikipedia and NASDAQ for the dividend history. So let's get into that. Okay, here's Capital One Wikipedia. I'm just going to breeze through this. I'm not going to go in depth with this. If you want more information, you know where to find it. Capital One Financial Corporation is a bank holding company specializing in credit cards, auto loans, banking, and savings account, headquartered in McLean, Virginia. So I use Capital One for the credit card. I currently have a Quicksilver, which with that Quicksilver card, I use that to purchase physical precious metals, which is specifically silver. And then I have another card from Capital One called the Platinum MasterCard. And with that card, I purchase platinum, physical precious metal platinum. So, and I use that just so, you know, because of the cards, it's a strategy that I use, but you know, I just came up with the idea when I received the Quicksilver. I was like, huh, let me start investing, just buying silver bars, you know, with the Quicksilver credit card. And then with the Platinum Master. I was like, okay, since I'm doing the Quicksilver with buying silver with the Quicksilver credit card, with the Platinum MasterCard, let me go ahead and start buying Platinum with the Platinum MasterCard. So gold and palladium, they're up in like the 1500 range. It's just way out of my range. But for me to compensate with for gold and palladium, I invest in ETFs. So here's just a little rundown on Capital One. Here's the Capital One Tower in Tysons, Virginia. There's the logo. You know, as you can see, I'm not gonna go through this. Kind of like breeze through here. Capital One is ranked 10th on the list of largest banks in the United States by assets. The bank has 755 branches, including 30 cafe-style locations and 2,000 ATMs. It is ranked 98th on the Fortune 500, 17th on Fortune's 100 Best Companies to Work For list, and conducts business in the United States, Canada, and the United Kingdom. The company helped pioneer the mass marketing of credit cards in the 1990s and 2016. It was the fifth largest credit card issuer by purchase volume after American Express, JP Morgan, Chase, Bank of America, and Citigroup. With a market share of 5%, Capital One is also the second largest auto finance company in the United States, following Ally Financial. In the fourth quarter of 2018, 75% of the company's revenues were from credit cards, 14% were from consumer banking, and 11% were from commercial banking. Okay, so there you have it. The background on Capital One on Wikipedia. All right, let's go into Capital One Finance dividend history on NASDAQ. So as you can see, I like this setup. This is a new interface. So this is Capital One Financial Corporation common stock, ticker symbol COF. I mean, it has the data as of December 31st, 2019, $102. It shows for a share that you can purchase. And it goes, all right, this is the dividend history. It shows the COF ex-dividend date, the COF dividend yield, COF annual dividend, which is $1.60, and then the COF payout ratios if you're that in depth with dividends. And then I'm just going to go to the beginning of May. I'm going to stay in 2019. So pretty much they pay 40 cents every 3 months. So 3 months is a quarter. So every quarter they pay 40 cents. Capital One. So there you have it. That's Capital One. This is my thoughts on Capital One. Well, the newest addition added to my portfolio. If any of you guys have Capital One, let me know. What are your strategies with it? Do you think it's a good buy? Not? Do you think they're a scam or anything like that? But I mean, my personal opinion, I love it. So Capital One, I mean, that's where I use when I started investing in the precious metals, the physical precious metals. You know, I was like, I gotta get buy a stock. So pretty much, I'm trying to buy the entire global stock market. I got a book coming out called The Blueprint for the Global Stock Market. So happy New Year's. I'll catch you tomorrow. While you're slaying dragons, I'll be taming them. Deuce.